I am Mehdi, I'm 26 years old, I'm from France.
And I'm Gabriel, I'm 27, I'm from Paris.
When we met 7 years ago, we realized we had a lot in common. We love traveling, we love Les Bleus, our French national team. Gabriel told me about the joys of bike touring. So after a trip in Italy last year to support the French national team, we thought it would be amazing to live a great adventure for 3 months to go to Qatar for the World Cup to cheer for our friends. So we started in France, then Germany, then Austria, Slovakia, Hungary, Serbia, Bulgaria, Turkey, Cyprus, Israel and Palestine, Jordan and Saudi.
So in Saudi Arabia, many people are stopping us on the side of the road to do what? Just to film us, because they've never seen cyclists.
Shukran.
We didn't expect that much generosity and hospitality. We didn't know what would happen there. We didn't expect anything, I guess, from Saudi. We just heard a lot of things in media and about petrol, especially.
Thank you so much. People, they just see us and they invite us for dinner. They don't even know how our name or stuff like that. Or people we meet, we tell them we're going in this direction, and then 50 kilometers later, it turns out they have groceries in their car, and then they drove all the way just to catch up with us and to offer us these supplies while we are just riding our bike in the desert.
Salam!
Wow, wow, wow!
Shukran! Shukran!
You come from Paris, huh?
Yes!
Looks like it's in the DNA of people here. And it maybe it will change us because we might become maybe more generous, I don't know.
We invite everyone who has a prejudice about Islam to just experience it by themselves. We've been through Turkey, Jordan, Saudi, and we were offered generosity that sometimes we didn't think was possible.
The image that the media bring us from countries is one thing, and discovering by yourself is something different. We've seen things through our own eyes. Like almost every night, we will just try and find a good spot to put up our tents. The criteria for a good spot should be quiet, away from people's look, and we'll have a look.
Let's go.
We'll just go have a look around. Over there is some grass, which is very comfortable. This is an option behind the wall. There is sand, it's dark. Gabriel saw another spot over there, so we have to check. And the mosque is always an option. Especially tomorrow, we're waking up early, so we won't be disturbed by the prayer at 5 a.m. because we are leaving early. So that may be an option as well. It's the best option we have. It's not amazing, but it's gonna be comfortable. Mon gars, on a géré.
C'est fait, encore une journée. It's a 5-star hotel, but 5-star on the sky only.
Good night. Ouais.
Ça
va nous manquer, hein.
Le Jaïn.
Grave. Masalama. Masalama, khouya.
Parce qu'on est à combien de Doha?
On est à
137 du Qatar.
137 km de la frontière qatari.
Yes.
C'est bon ça.
We finally reached Qatar. It's our 13th country. We've made 7,000 kilometers for 3 months.
It was very hard on the bikes, very tough physically, but so many adventures, so many people met, so many great places visited. The reason why we embarked on this journey is very simple. We wanted to live adventures on our bicycle and collect a lot of memories for the two of us and experience our friendship and strengthen it, and that was it. That's all.
Ciao bello. Du monde les gars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 coupes du monde. C'est des arnaques, ces mecs-là. Con mi amigo somos de Francia.
We're very happy to be discovering both the World Cup and Qatar. We can feel that the atmosphere is getting warmer and warmer every day. In terms of sports, it's probably going to be a crazy and really interesting tournament to see and to witness, because there are so many good teams out there, and we can't wait to follow the tournament.
Welcome to the Al-Janoub Stadium.
Now we're done after more than 7,000 kilometers from Paris. We're here now in Doha and ready to support the French team. So, allez les Bleus!
Allez, Bleu.
We have lots of things waiting for us. So, now let's go!